Hey everyone, this is Andrew Tai. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're going to be looking at the Z2 Top Case, which is a case for the iPad Air. So this is the iPad Air 5th generation with the M1 chip. And today I'm going to be doing a kind of unboxing and install of this particular case. So this one you can find on Amazon. I'll leave a link to this in the description. And we're going to go ahead and install it and see how it looks and feels. So this case has two parts. We've got the front cover part and we've got the back cover, which is nice because I don't really like installing screen protectors. And we've got our typical kind of cleaning products, but this is a brand new iPad, so I'm just going to install that straight away. You can just wipe it with this included microfiber cloth. So what's quite nice about the case that I've chosen is that it has this kind of front and back protectors too. Here we have disassembly instructions because it kind of comes pre-done. There's a little notch here on the edge, which I'm going to use to pop the front out. That removes that front cover. This is kind of the screen protector part, which is going to go over the top. What's this foam insert, which we don't need. And then the important part is the kind of back protection here. So I'm just going to show you how this works. So what we're going to do is we're going to align up the bottom port here with the notch at the bottom here. So basically this will just clip on top. But before we do that, we have another piece we need to do. We've removed this clear film. And now we are ready to pop this on. So we've got a notch here for the camera, and that goes in just like that. So now we've got our case. We'll get this corner in first, and then the last corner here. So that is pretty much all round protection, front and back, which is very, very nice. We have the volume buttons. We still have access to our power button here, so we can toggle this on and off. We have grills for the speakers here and also the microphone array. The two speaker arrays here with the charge port being protected here. So I just want to address a few concerns that I normally have when I get an iPad case. So one of them is that we don't have a home button. We have to do a swipe from the bottom. And sometimes the lip of a case might override the edge where you have to do the swipe to get back to home. And fortunately, we don't have this issue. So I can open up a game and I can go in and out very easily. So this lip, this bezel is not being obscured by the case, so that's great. The other thing is that the power button here is also a Touch ID button, and I haven't actually had any issues using Touch ID on here, so I can switch this on and log in straight away without doing a passcode at all. That's recessed a little bit, so it can be a little bit tricky to get, but your finger, if you just place it over the entire button, then you should be able to get the ID to work properly. The other thing is that the kickstand actually doubles up both as a landscape kickstand and a portrait kickstand. So here I've got the kickstand like so, and I can pull this down like that, and that gives this kind of edge like that. So that means I can have it sitting up like this, and I can use it hands-free. So it's a great positioning like that. But I also have the option here to use it as a portrait mode too. And you'll find that it's a little bit unstable. However, there is an extra flap here. So if you look at that, that gives us kind of extra stability. And if I put it down now, then that's great. So it is not perfectly stable, not as good as landscape, but it works fine. The other thing is that the screen itself has a screen protector on top, which is quite thick, a lot thicker than your normal screen protector. However, the pen will still work. So I'm using this third-party pen, not an Apple Pencil 2, but a third-party one. And this actually works great on this screen surface. I'll just show you how it works. So even if I have a surface like this, I can do all my drawings like that. And this works great even on this screen protected case. So this works perfectly. And then I've also got this handy recess area to put that pencil there. So overall, this case works great. I do recommend it. It's got a good feel to it. It's a little bit plasticky, especially at the back, but the front has got a nice kind of rubbery, silicony feel to it. Last thing as well is just look at the cameras and whether they're obscured. So I've got my camera here at the back, which is not obscured. And then if I flip the camera up, look at my camera display, that's all fine too. So none of that is covered up either. So anyway, this is a really nice case. I do quite like it so far. I hope you found this video useful. I'm gonna leave a link to this in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.